So good afternoon, my name is Kirsten Jackson. I'm from the Research and Implementation Science and eHealth group at New South Wales. Yeah, good. Sorry. So the presentation I'm doing today is about a project that we're doing that investigates the ability to visualize electronic health data in order to support MDTs to monitor their delivery of care and engage in quality improvement. So with this project, we've been working very closely with the Westmead Breast Cancer Institute and the Sarcoma MDT at the Crown Princess Mary Cancer Center to refine what data teams wanted to be seeing and how they wanted to be seeing it. So our project had three steps, the first of which was to identify and prioritize all possible indicators. So by indicators here, I mean things like treatment processes, outcomes, as well as service provision measurements. So the first thing we did for this was complete an environmental scan and collated all possible indicators for breast and sarcoma streams. So this resulted in about close to 400, definitely over 300, but obviously we couldn't address all of these. So what we did was run workshops with key clinical staff members and subject matter experts to review and prioritize all of the indicators based on evidence, clinical significance, whether the measure was actionable, and if it was appropriate for benchmarking. So from 300, we reduced them quite significantly. The next section of the project was looking at the data that we needed for those indicators. So we knew there was a whole pile of systems, but we needed to check for each indicator what data was needed and could we access it, as well as how complete it was. So as an example here, we knew that we could access Cerner. So immediately a lot of indicators we could address. Some of them we weren't sure of, and some of them we definitely couldn't get. The last aspect of this project was the feedback loop, so how we actually visualized that data and gave it back to teams. So we created consolidated data sets, and we trialed the use of a dashboard in order to test whether this was something that was feasible and acceptable in a clinical setting. So what we actually first started doing after collating and prioritizing all of our indicators was do a test, so a proof of concept project, specifically on lymphedema. So we chose lymphedema because this was a direct side effect of breast cancer treatment. We knew we could access some digitized retrospective data on it, and we also knew that by aggregating and presenting back this data, clinical teams could answer some key clinical questions. So things like what proportion of patients had lymphedema, which patients were at higher risk and needed an early referral, and what was the relationship between the type of treatment given and lymphedema measurements. So we evaluated this prototype, and obviously with any kind of thing, we got some positives and areas for concern. Some of the positives we found were that MDTs really thought this could be a good clinical support decision tool. So they liked that we had top-level cohort data, but could drill down to patient-specific information. We found that color coding worked well, and that clear visualizations were better understood. We also found out that visualizing data could be really helpful in highlighting data errors or areas for improvement while collecting data, which was a positive of that bit. So some of the barriers we did find out were that, similar to that, data quality was poor, and we also had to get it from multiple systems, which was quite hard. We found that clinical knowledge was still key to interpreting the results. So you could display a measurement, but what that actually meant and how you actioned it was always up to the clinician using it. We also found that varying levels of engagement and confidence using technology really impacted the way that something was implemented. So what we're currently working on is breast cancer and sarcoma dashboards, looking at both the oncological outcomes and service provision indicators for both of those. So throughout the review process, out of several hundred, we got all of our indicators down to about 100, and then finally 32 for breast cancer and 12 for sarcoma. So the final requirements have been developed and documented with a huge amount of input from our subject matter experts. So we had surgeons, medical oncologists, radio-oncologists, care coordinators, pathologists, the center directors, and administrators. As one of the key learnings from the lymphedema dashboard was that co-design was essential in getting a good visualization and outcome. So through this iterative process, each indicator was defined, so exactly what it meant. We assessed the availability and completeness of the data relevant to it, and on multiple occasions, we actually updated the process for collecting data so that teams could feedback on these indicators. So The reason that it's jumped here, I can see sarcoma had 8 and it went to 12, is because along the way, a lot of our indicators got split and merged. So for example, one of our indicators was looking at the percentage of patients that were T2 triple negative or HER2 positive with breast cancer and then recommended for neoadjuvant chemotherapy, which we actually decided to split because the MDT decided they could action those separately, and from a data point of view was a lot easier to analyze. So where we're currently at is creating a whole lot of mock-ups and testing some of the visualizations with the team. So we've been doing workshops to make sure that we've got the right scales for each measurement. We're also using the correct language, and even testing things like different colors for specific things and adding targets to our visualizations. So an example of that is one of our requirements was looking at the percentage of patients that were diagnosed with cancer and seen within 5 days at an MDT. Instead of a bar graph that showed patients seen within 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days, we just wanted to look at number of patients seen within 5 days and number of patients not seen within 5 days. So next up, for the project, we're currently appointing a data engineer to sit jointly between Sydney Uni and Westmead, so that person can be really well embedded in the data teams there and help with implementation and delivery. We'd obviously like to deliver our sarcoma and breast cancer dashboards and evaluate those and disseminate the findings. And we'd also like to trial using these dashboards across sites or across MDTs to do some benchmarking research. More broadly in data and visualizations in the health perspective, we'd really like to see more consolidated sets of data so that we can do more powerful analytics and run analytics and visualizations off live data sources. We can definitely see a use of visualizations to support data accuracy and data quality ongoing for teams. And it would also be really great to see how visualizations can be used as an aid to help consumers and patients be educated about their own health journeys, as well as feeding back to clinicians so that there's things like general reporting and staff development much easily done. So just finally, I'd like to thank the guys that we're involved in at the Breast Cancer Institute and the Crown Princess Mary Cancer Center. They spent so much time and expertise with us, so thanks again.
Thank you, Kirsten. That was really, really interesting. Can I see if anybody in the audience has any questions for Kirsten? No? Okay, I have a question. So you mentioned that you are looking to spread this out across the LHD. What kinds of challenges do you think you'll face, given that there'll be different systems in different organisations?
So the biggest challenges for us will probably be finding the right data. So obviously each LHD seems to use fairly different systems, even to collect the same data. And also getting people to see the value in doing some benchmarking across things. There's a lot of pockets of people who definitely appreciate that, but obviously you have to go through a bit higher management to get people to sign on and share their data, which will be a big challenge for us.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.